Hey, what's up, guys? This is Torrance from Tech Portal, and today I'm going to show you how to fly a freaking pelican. For this tutorial, you're going to need a USB drive with at least 2 GB of space, an Xbox 360, a computer, and a brain. Once you've booted up your Xbox 360, head over to System Settings and then select Memory. Now, insert your USB drive into one of the USB ports on the front of your Xbox. Once the Xbox has detected it, select USB Storage Device and configure Now and Yes. By the way, before you do this, make sure you back up all the files on your USB drive, as this is going to delete everything that's on it. Depending on the size of your USB drive, it can take anywhere from 30 seconds to 5 minutes to complete this configuration process. I use a 4 GB drive, and it takes about half a minute. If you get a performance warning, just click OK and don't worry about it. Once the configuration process is over, head back over to your Xbox main menu and select Sign In. Then, hover over to Profile Creation and create a new profile on the device that you just configured. You can name the profile whatever you want, as it doesn't really matter. When you get to the avatar creator, just choose a random avatar, as that also doesn't really matter. Once you've selected a random avatar, you can save and exit. Once you're back at your Xbox's main menu, you can turn off your Xbox, take out the USB drive, and stick it into your computer. Now I'm going to show you guys what you need to do on your computer so you can pilot the freaking pelican. The first thing you need to do is click the link I have in the description and download the files that I'm going to provide for you guys. You're also going to need WinRAR to open the file, so if you don't have that, there'll be another link for you guys to get WinRAR. So, after you have the file downloaded, you're going to click Open. And then, drag these two files onto your desktop. So, now you should have this folder right here, and Explorer USB on your desktop. So, now that you have those two files on your desktop, take your USB drive out of your Xbox 360 and stick it into your computer. Once you've done that, right-click Explorer USB and click Run as Administrator. Once Explorer USB is open, click File and Open Drive, expand Data Partition and Content. Now, you're going to take the folder that you dragged onto your desktop earlier and drag it into your content folder on Explorer USB. Now you should have two profiles in your content folder. You should have the one that you created earlier, the dummy profile that you gave a random name, and the profile that you just dragged into it. Once you have that profile dragged into the content folder, click File, Close Drive. And then just close Explorer USB. So now what you want to do is take your USB drive out of your computer and stick it back in your Xbox. I'm going to do that right now and then show you guys what to do from there. Now that you're back on your Xbox, you want to sign in the profile that you dragged into your USB using Explorer USB. So, press the guide button, hit sign in, and then sign into the account Tech Portal. As you can see, there's the random account we created, but we're going to sign into Tech Portal. Now just boot up your Halo Reach. When it asks you to choose your memory device, make sure you choose memory unit, as that's the USB drive we used. Select main menu and then go into a campaign lobby. You should have the option to resume campaign, and that's what we're going to be doing. Once the campaign mission is all loaded up, select resume slow campaign. If you did everything right, you should be able to fly the Pelican around the map. You can't fly too far and you can't fly too fast, but you know, it's still pretty cool.
My name is Optimus Prime.
Also, remember to subscribe, rate, and comment for more Halo Reach videos.